Assalamualaikum. Hello everyone. This video is talking about context and context. Both are related each other. Context is words that surround another word or the linguistic environment of a word. While context is circumstances that contains meaning. In bahasa, konteks adalah teks itu sendiri, yaitu hubungan antara satu kata dengan kata yang lain membentuk kalimat dan hubungan kalimat dengan kalimat yang lain yang akhirnya membentuk teks. Nah, teks tersebut memiliki hubungan satu sama lain sehingga menciptakan kalimat yang bisa kita pahami maknanya, yaitu konteks. Di dalam konteks ada yang namanya situasi, kemudian topik atau apa yang dibicarakan, lokasi, waktu, dan sebagainya. What is text? Text is a textual information. It is the linguistic content or the stable semantic meanings of words, expressions, and sentences, but not the inferences available to hearers depending upon the context in which words, expressions, and sentences are used. Teks syarat dengan informasi dan di dalamnya memiliki makna semantik atau makna leksikal dan mengandung ekspresi kalimat, tapi tidak ada makna yang tersirat di dalamnya, sehingga pembaca atau pendengar hanya mengandalkan pada konteks yang memiliki makna dari kata-kata yang terdapat dalam teks itu sendiri dan bagaimana teks itu mengekspresikan kata tersebut. Okay, now we go to context. What's context? It is setting of a word or event, and it is thus a world filled with people producing utterances. People who have social, cultural, and personal identities, knowledge, beliefs, goals, and wants, and to interact with one another in very socially and culturally defined situation. Context memiliki informasi sehingga kita bisa memaknainya berdasarkan peristiwa, setting, bagaimana people atau orang-orang atau speaker berbicara, memproduksi ujaran, bagaimana mereka berinteraksi secara sosial, budaya, di mana mereka juga identitas berpengaruh, pengetahuan, kepercayaan, tujuan, dan keinginan ketika mereka berinteraksi satu sama lain, baik secara sosial maupun budaya, tergantung dari situasi di mana mereka berada atau ketika mereka melakukan percakapan. The context is the linguistic environment in which the referring expression is immersed. The context then is the physical environment. Yeah, both are the difference between context and context. Context itu apa yang terucap, ya? Yeah? dan sehingga di situ mengandung teks, baik itu di dalam percakapan dan apa yang tertulis di situ oleh penulis. Sedangkan konteks kita melihat secara makna, secara meaningnya, apa yang bisa kita tarik maknanya di dalam teks tersebut. Context means co-plus text. Co means together, a company in the vicinity. Linguistic context is co-text internal, depend on the linguistic unit which comes before or after one in question. For example, the word of green. She's wearing green hat. Yeah, green here means color. John is green. He is not to do the work well. Green here means inexperience, less experience. The fruit is green. Do not eat it. Green means unripe, not good for consumed. Dari satu kata, jika diterapkan pada kalimat yang berbeda, maka artinya pun berbeda, seperti kata green itu sendiri. Context of a word is a set of other words used in the same phrase or sentence before or after the word. Yeah. And the surrounding context has a strong effect on what we think the word probably means. Context, as I explained you, that the set of other words atau kumpulan kata-kata yang digunakan dalam frase atau kalimat sebelum atau sesudah kata yang dianggap memiliki poin. And the surround for example, in the sentence, the bank will open soon. The context help us to understand the intended meaning of the word bank. Sama seperti tadi, ini penggunaan bank, apakah bank to deposit money or bank the edge of river. The context clearly limits the range of possible interpretations we might have for word. Of course, context is just a linguistic part of the environment in which a referring expression is used. The physical environment or context is perhaps more easily recognized as having a powerful impact on how words are to be interpreted. There are three types of context: context of a culture, context of utterance, and context of reference. The culture, it relates to the social, economical, or cultural conventions or history or the discourse or text. While context of utterance, situation within which discourse is conducted, for example, physical surroundings or space or setting, the people participating, the channel, oral, visual, electronic, written, the time. Context of reference, it relates to the topic, fields of domain, or subject, or theme. In bahasa, I can explain you. Context of culture, artinya adalah yang kaitannya dengan sosial, budaya, baik itu hubungannya dengan ekonomi, sejarah, dan sebagainya. Sedangkan context of utterance, itu ujaran, di mana di dalamnya pasti ada kumpulan orang yang berinteraksi satu sama lain. Dan di dalamnya termasuk setting, kemudian channel atau menggunakan apa interaksinya, kemudian kaitannya dengan visual, apakah menggunakan elektronik atau written, dan pada waktu tertentu. That's the difference context of utterance, physical surrounding, location of participants, that includes there. In context of culture, it can include social, economic institution, and the reference is includes the topic. What we can take the point from that conversation, for instance. Okay, what does cultural context means? It includes the behavior, ideas, and beliefs shared by individuals within a particular group of people. This group can be based around age, ethnicity, or social standing. Culture is learned, and it includes language, values, norms, and customs related to the particular group. Jadi budaya itu meliputi komplit, ya, baik itu perilaku, ideas, keyakinan yang disampaikan oleh perorangan di grup atau di kelompok tertentu atau area tertentu yang meliputi berbagai usia, etnis, dan sosial. Selain itu, budaya itu dipelajari, tidak serta-merta muncul begitu saja, karena budaya mengandung nilai-nilai, bahasa, dan norma yang diterapkan oleh dan dilaksanakan oleh masyarakat tertentu. Okay, context cultures. Ada negara yang memiliki budaya, situasi budaya yang sangat tinggi adabnya, sehingga disebut high context culture, dan sebaliknya low context culture. Social context affects the meaning of the message. Context is as important or more important as what is said. For example, Japan and Saudi Arabia. And it is called low context culture, is where the meaning of the message is explicitly expressed by the words. Social context has less effect, for example, North America. So we can conclude here. It depends on the way how they interact each other and care for another. For example, here high context is China, Japan, France. So no worries if you are going there. And low context, it is like when you can see the people is like individuals has high privacy. It's like USA, Scandinavia, Germany. In the high context, interpretation of messages heavily rests of contextual clues, nature of relationships, sender, receiver, time and set communication, etc. In the low context, emphasis put on the written or spoken word. What is meant is what is said. The context within which messages are communicated is largely discounted. Jadi bedanya adalah pada low context, itu apa yang disampaikan, yaitu semisal di Amerika tidak mengenal bahasa basi. Ketika kita ditawari untuk makan, terus kita menjawab tidak karena sudah kenyang, mereka tidak akan menawarkan lagi atau tidak akan merayu-rayu orang tersebut untuk makan. Berbeda dengan Indonesia atau Japan, China, mereka lebih peduli, mereka lebih tepo seliro. Okay, it is in a difference, low context and high context again. In the low context, exchange of info focus on word and is direct. Jadi mereka lebih langsung to the point, sedangkan high context itu implicit. Seperti kita ngomong A, tapi sebenarnya ada maksud lain di balik itu. Kemudian secara meaning, low context yaitu yang seperti orang-orang di Amerika, meaning and what you say. Sedangkan high context meaning is also how you say things and what is not said. Lebih ke implicit. Seperti yang saya sampaikan tadi, and the task-centered communication, the low context, it is centered to the communication, while in the high context, it focus on the relationship oriented, I hope you can distinguish it. Jadi pada low context yang berada di kulturnya orang Amerika, mereka lebih kayak mereka lebih berpusat pada komunikasi, sedangkan seperti orang kita lebih berorientasikan hubungan. Dan bedanya lagi, in a low context the use of I is important, sedangkan in a high context the use of we is more important. You can see the examples of high context culture, the countries such as African, Arab, Brazilian, Chinese, Filipinos, Indonesian, yeah, that I told you before. Okay. While countries which has low context cultures like Australian, English Canadian, English Finnish, the communication is explicit and straightforward, and less importance is placed on word choice, and individualism and independence are valued here. Okay, now we are talking about context of an utterance. Context of an utterance is a small subpart of the universe of discourse shared by speakers and hearers, and it includes facts about the topic of conversation in which the utterance occurs, and also facts about the situation in which the conversation itself takes place. Jadi berdasarkan konteks of an utterance itu berdasarkan percakapan dengan topik tertentu oleh pembicara dan interlocutors, atau antara speaker 1 dan speaker 2 pada situasi tertentu dan di mana percakapan berlangsung. Talking about communicative competence, according to Dilheims, it is the aspect of our competence that enables us to convey and interpret messages and to negotiate meanings interpersonally within specific contexts, while, according to Chomsky, it is the account sufficiently for the social and functional rules of language. We can conclude here that communicative competence itu sangat penting, ya, bagi kita, supaya kita bisa memahami speaker ketika kita sebagai pendengar, dan kita juga memahami dengan siapa kita bicara, lalu lokasi juga di mana kita berbicara. Maka dari itu komunikatif kompeten sangat diperlukan agar kita bisa menginterpretasi pesan, bagaimana kita bisa menyampaikan pesan, dan bagaimana kita bisa memahami makna dengan situasi tertentu. Sedangkan dan itu pun juga sama halnya dengan yang disampaikan oleh Chomsky, bahwa communicative competence itu berhubungan dengan sosial, fungsi sosial, dan peraturan sosial yang berpengaruh pada bahasa. Kecakapan berbicara menurut Dilheims ada grammatical competence, social competence, sociolinguistic competence, discourse competence, and strategic competence. Kalau bisa saya jelaskan di sini, ya, kecakapan berbicara, kita tahu grammarnya, ya, kalau itu berhubungan dengan bahasa Inggris, begitupun di bahasa Indonesia atau bahasa apapun. Kita juga memiliki kecakapan bersosial, sosiolinguistik, bersosial dan berbahasa. Kemudian discourse competence, di sini kita memahami dan bisa menarik makna atas pesan yang tersampaikan ke kita. Dan strategic competence, kita bisa menyampaikan pesan, berbicara berstrategi sesuai dengan siapa kita berbicara, sesuai dengan lokasi di mana kita berbicara, dan sebagainya. Okay, talking about speaking, this one, according to Dale Himes, ini sebenarnya akan dijelaskan di pertemuan berikutnya, ya. Namun ini tidak apa-apa, kalian nanti dibaca sendiri, ya. The relationship between character and content. Nah, character, it is a function from context of utterance to content. Fungsi karakter atau watak, ya, dalam situasi ujaran, dan akan berpengaruh pada isi dan bagaimana ujaran itu, bagaimana situasi dalam ujaran itu. Dan apa yang disampaikan oleh speaker merujuk ke mana begitu. Di dalam teks ada yang namanya theme and rhyme. You learn this in systemic functional grammar, right? It helps us understand how information is conveyed in clauses. Writers put the theme first and this orients the readers to what is about to be communicated. The rest of the clause tells the reader something about the theme, and this rest of the clause is called the rhyme. For instance, Microsoft have expanded in China recently. Temanya adalah Microsoft, kemudian rhyme itu have expanded in China recently. Contoh lain seperti ini. Our dog Rufus limped into the room. His back paw was red with infection. That's all for the explanation. Hope you understand this, and please let me know if you do not understand. Have a nice day and good luck. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.